to make these stinking things so non-intuitive. Excuse me, young lady. I'm trying to take a picture of that Adobe over there. And all it's doing is trying to give me shelfies, or whatever they call them.
Selfies.
Oh, I knew that. I knew that. You know, there's... That's me in there. Oh, and now there's a picture of my thumb. And it wants me to go to the iTunes store. Oh, geez. Can you get the camera to work?
Sure. First, you have to press this button.
Uh-huh.
And then tap here.
Okay.
And tap here.
And there.
Then here.
And there.
Then go back to the home screen.
Go back to home screen. Okay.
And put your thumb right there.
I'm not going to take a picture of it. Okay.
Now take a picture.
Why would
you want to take a picture of this old building anyway? It seems pretty lame to me.
Lame? That is the oldest still standing building in Contra Costa County. It's even older than me. Hell, it's even older than Bobby Landers.
Like, before the internet?
Way before the internet. Before Al Gore, whoever he was.
And it's still here?
Yeah. If those walls could talk, well, they'd have lots of stories to tell about La Mirinda history.
The history of La Mirinda? Like back when they took those pictures that are hanging in the Village Inn Cafe? That place's French toast is legendary.
Oh, no. This is real legendary. This is the history of... The Adobe and the people that lived there. Now that, young lady, is some story. That is the stuff of legends. Now, I'm glad you asked me that.
Well, tell me about it then.
I jumped under line. I'm glad you asked me that because I've got my notes here. As the Moraga Adobe historian, it all started in 1835. When Joaquin Moraga and his cousin, Juan Bernal, were given 13,000 acres of land, which included what's now Orinda, Moraga, and parts of Lafayette. Well, let Joaquin tell it.
I'll tell it, okay. Excuse me, little lady. I grew up in the army. Like my dad did before, my grandfather Jose, helped Spain colonize the shore. He founded San Francisco and the lands nearby. He commanded the Presidio. He was a pretty badass guy, yeah. At 3 years in the army, that was 1835. I had just left the service and I was happy to be alive. Me and my cousin Juan Bernal here, yes, he received a generous grant. 13,000 acres from the Mexican government. Welcome to Rancho Laguna de los Colorados. Such a lovely place. Such wide open space. Hey! Welcome to Rancho Laguna de los Gallos Colorados. In a few more years, we'll have settled here. Just above Moraga Valley, around 1841. I built this adobe, wishing I could live in with my son. And we built up a salon with a wooden dance floor. A bedroom with a kitchen just down the corridor. Keep on going, it's on the left. You got it, good. Keep going. Then we started throwing fandangos and they were parties for our friends. We'd invite anybody and wish it would never end. How they dance in the salon. Sweet summer sweat. Some dances I remember, but most of them I forget, eh? Everybody sing! Rancho Laguna de los Palos Colorados! Such a lovely place. Such wide open space. Rancho Laguna de los Palos Colorados! In 200 years, I hope it's still standing here. The crops are good, the herd is healthy, and best of all, el presidente Polk and el gobierno de los Estados Unidos recognize the land grants. Let's celebrate, everybody! Pistols!
Jump to my line. No kid of mine.
You're welcome.
By 1848, before the gold rush, Moraga and Bernal had transformed the dusty rancho into a successful farming operation. They sold hides and tallow through San Francisco sailing companies to markets on the East Coast and Europe. They used cattle and surplus crops to barter for what the rancho couldn't either grow or make. As a result of the war with Mexico, California was ceded to the United States. Although we actually paid $500 million in settlement of the claims of displaced Mexican citizens that were moved off the Southwest territories that became the United States as a result. Also in the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo, the U.S. decided, well, to honor the claims and the deeds that created the land grants, such as the ones that Moraga and Bernal had. So at this point, Joaquin and Juan thought the rancho was pretty much secure, even though there was a different boss in charge of the state of California. To celebrate the Americans recognizing the grants from Mexico, the cousins held a Fandango at the Moraga Adobe. So let's look in on them. You can see the dons from the neighboring ranches and their wives, the farmhands, and maybe a few Indians who live nearby in lean-tos.
This is a very popular dance called El Sombrero Blanco.
¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida en trono? ¿Para que te cante el turrum, 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 turrum? Si quieres que yo te quiera, ¿quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida y un trono? ¿Para que te cante el tu-ru-ru-ru-ru-ru-ru? ¿Es posible, Padre mío, que me vaya a padecer y que vaya a pasar trabajos por causa de una ¿quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida y un trono? ¿Para que te cante el tu, 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 tu? Si
si quieres que yo te quiera, ha de ser por condición que el tuyo va a ser mío y lo mío tuyo no. ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida en trono? Para que te cante el turno. ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida en trono? Para que te cante el turu-turu-turu-turu-turu. Si quieres que yo te quiera, ladrillar el mar. Y después de ladrillado, soy tuyo y puedes mandar. ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida en trono? Que te cante y que haya pasado trabajo por causa de una mujer. ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero blanco? ¿Quieres que te ponga mi sombrero azul? ¿Quieres que te siente mi vida en trono? ¿Para que te cante el
A dance that took California by storm was La Cachucha. It started in continental Europe. There was a very famous ballet dancer who was famous for doing it. It made it all the way here. La Cachucha. Thank you.
Everything wasn't all good times and fandangos. Following the gold rush, there came an influx of squatters. These were people who didn't strike it rich in the gold fields and didn't have a real good way of getting back to where they came from. So they decided to stick around. Show the squatters.
I've never seen gold dust in the flesh. I came here chasing my dreams. California. Oh, here's better. I don't have my own address. This isn't really a town. Got no post office. Everybody's like gold place, gold bars, come to California. Rivers flow with gold, come to California. So we came, and we found not one damn thing. Cause everybody's just picking, choosing, grabbing all the good land, sifting, shaking, taking all the good sand. Now we're here, and there's no government to fear. So we are just squatters.
Squatters.
We don't have a place to stand. The fans. A Moraga man, he doesn't need all of his land. Let me sleep in your rancho.
Rancho.
And take and pull up all your trees. And baby, we'll keep this land for free. Yeah. My friends and I, we crack the code. Though this isn't ours. Fear. So we are just squatters.
Squatters.
We don't have a place to stand. The fancy J. Moraga man. He doesn't need all of this land. Let me sleep in your rancho.
Rancho.
And take and pull up all your trees. And baby, we'll keep this land for free.
The squatters occupied and destroyed much of the land owned by Moraga and the Bernal families. Before his death, Joaquin Moraga was forced to sell several pieces of his land to pay his debts. But after his death, things got even worse. The Moragas were simple ranchers who didn't speak much, if any, English. So they were at the mercy of Contra Costa's most infuriating import, the dreaded East Coast lawyer. The Moraga and the Bernals never regained their land. Instead, it passed through a number of hands of owners. And the adobe remains as a reminder of the two families. It was designated a historical monument in 1945, and it's protected by a group of dedicated people called the Friends of the Joaquin Moraga Adobe. And I hear that they are accepting donations.
Wow, that is a pretty crazy story.
Well, it's your story, and you should share it.
Like on Facebook?
Facebook. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
It's kind of sad, though.
Yeah, it is. Especially if you were a Moraga or a Bernal. But that's history. It's the rising and falling of the fortunes of families interwoven with the tapestry of events. and those that alter and illumine our times, as someone once said. Now, it's a good thing that we have those founding families, because we might be standing here knee-deep in foxtails, blackberries, coyote brush and poison oak, maybe a few oaks, if it hadn't been for them and their decision to settle here. Exeunt.
Time kept on turning, and this country came of age. And over here in the East Bay, our history turned another page, so we put it on stage. And they build a tunnel, and they turned it Highway 24. And after years and years of traffic, they finally built that fourth bore. Sweet home La Mirinda, where the skies are always blue. Sweet home La Mirinda, I'll be coming home to you. In 41 they built a theater. You and I have seen a flick or two. When you're driving the commute, do those potholes bother you? Tell the truth, sweet home La Mirinda, where the skies are so blue. Sweet home La Mirinda, the Lord, I'm coming home to you.